you know about a great servant of God from Guntur area called Yesanna. He's a non-Christian. He was coughing blood. Yes, he was coughing blood. And he was becoming like mad. So his whole village decided that he is a waste guy. He was roaming around. He was roaming around. And one day, he went to a prayer meeting. He heard the word of God. Jesus is the healer. Jesus is a merciful God. Then Yesanna said, maybe Jesus is merciful, but I am a number one steal. I have stolen so many things. I am a thief. I have lived a worst life. I have hit so many people. But Jesus said, he heard the clear voice, my son, I will heal you. And I will use you mightily. And as he was sleeping, the Bible says, when you trust in the Lord, 1 Corinthians 2:9, what no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no one imagined, is the thing the Lord will do for you. Suddenly, the Lord was saying, sing the songs. He said, Lord, I have never sung in my life. How can I sing, Lord? The Lord said, sing. He gave the song. And he began to sing. Some of the people said, this is not according to the raga. You sing this and that. So in the beginning, he was feeling a little bad. But the Lord said, I am giving you the song. And by the time Brother Yesanna died, he composed hundreds of songs which were sung by millions of people. And every song led people to God. Yes. Don't worry about your position, your qualification. Look unto the Lord. Build up your confidence in the Lord and constantly renew your mind. And the Lord will heal you of all your sickness, of body, mind and spirit. And he will use you. Fourth, if the divine mercy have to heal you, number one, not merely run to the servants of God and get upset if they say something. Number two, don't lose your life of prayer and confidence in the Lord. Number three, let anything happen, you constantly renew your mind. Number four, if the divine mercy has to heal you, don't ignore the dark side of your life. The Bible says, confess your sin, leave your sin if the sickness have to leave you. If you are holding on to sin and you want the divine mercy to heal you, sorry, it will not take place. So leave your sin. Don't ignore the dark part of your life. And then the divine mercy will heal you. I remember once I had made a commitment and everything was going on well. Suddenly, yes, mistake had happened to me in my life. So I felt so sorry. When I did that mistake, suddenly the man who promised to do the things, he just went 180 degree opposite. He said, I will not do it. I said, if you are not doing it, how is it possible? I came back to the chapel and began to cry. The Lord said, don't cry. I said, Lord, this man is first accepted. I have given the advance. Now he is saying he will not do it. It is your money. So what? He said. I did not understand the Lord speaking like that. The Lord said, look into your life. You are growing in sin. And you are not coming out of that sin. And without coming out of your sin, and you want to serve me, who wants your service, man? Who want your service? First, cleanse your life. I said, I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry, Lord. Please forgive me, Lord. The whole night I was in tears. I could not sleep. Oh, the power of sin. It will take away all our blessings. Oh, the power of sin. It will bring curses into our lives. Don't play with your dark side of life. If the divine mercy have to do his work of mercy in our lives, we have to come out of it. We read in the book of Numbers chapter 25. The people of Israel were led by the Lord. The mercy of God was leading them in the desert at night in the form of light, in the daytime in the form of clouds. But the enemy wanted to destroy them. So the Midianite women were brought and they were dancing naked, and the drinks were available in the desert, and the Midianite people were offering to their gods worship. So some of the Israelites, they left the camp, and they were going around sinning with the women of Midianite women and drinking alcohol. When they went away from God, as we are having corona, that day a terrible sickness came, and so many people are dying, including those who are coming out of the desert to inside the camp. Inside people are also dying, and the sickness is spreading like anything. Moses and Aaron, they did not know what to do. They were crying to the Lord. And one fellow, an Israelite, not only he went out and sinned with that Midianite woman, and she brought that Midianite woman inside the camp of Israelites. Not only today I have sinned, I will keep this lady with me. I can sin tomorrow also. When a young man called Phinehas, when he saw this, his zeal for the Lord became so great. He was so upset. Stupid fellow, you went out of our camp, you sinned with that lady, and you brought that lady also again inside the camp, inside our tent. So he took the spear and went and poked him and killed that man and killed that lady and threw them out of the camp, threw away their bodies. The Bible says, immediately the sickness stopped. God looks for people who have the zeal for him, who have fear of God. People who have fear of God and zeal for his kingdom, zeal for holiness. These are the people will stop corona. Do you want corona to be stopped? Take care. You and your family increases the zeal for God. Increase the holiness for God. And the enemy can never come near us. Yes. And that's what happened that day. Don't ignore the dark side of your life. The divine mercy wants to come and heal you. Have the self-deliverance as you lift up your hand. Wherever you are, kneel before the Lord and cry to him. Lord, my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, Lord. My body is the temple, and I have allowed all kinds of dark elements to enter into my life. I pray divine mercy chaplet, but no healing is coming, Lord. Maybe I have lost my confidence in you. Maybe I, my prayer life, I am not conquering praying like Ezekiah. I have lost the confidence in you. Maybe the enemy has made me to be a man of fear, and my mind is not renewed. Maybe I'm not touching the dark aspect of my life without purifying myself, without having any zeal and hunger for you. I'm trying to cry to you, have mercy on me and on my whole world. and nothing is happening to me, Lord. Lord, I come into your presence. You said, Lord, no power that aimed against you will prosper. And that is what God has kept for his children. Lord, in the name of yours, Jesus, I ask, Lord, you said whatever we ask in your name, it will happen to us. In Jesus' name, I arrest every evil, Lord. I repent for my sin, Lord. I repent for the moments I was lukewarm, Lord. I was not alert like King Hezekiah. I did not have confidence like Daniel. I did not renew the minds of us like the friends of Daniel. Lord, I was not having zeal for you like Pinhas. You are showing all these people, Lord, to us, that we may be healed. Your divine mercy may enter into our lives. Mary Magdalene, a sinner, came to you, Lord, and your mercy came upon her. A thief, even in the dying moment, he cried to you, Lord, Jesus, remember me, because he had confidence in you. And he is saying, we are sinners, when he was crying. Yes, Lord, your word says in the book of Proverbs 28 verse 13, anyone covers his sin will not prosper. But if anyone acknowledges one's sins and repents for his sins and return to God, the healing power of God will come upon. Lord, we are crying to you. Let your living water flow on. Sweep away our pain, Lord. Bring your healing to our hearts, Lord. Lord, I command every spirit, all of you kneel down. Wherever you have sickness, now place your hands over there. And the divine mercy is with you. Like Hezekiah, look at him and say, Lord, you are my God, I trust in you. Like Daniel, you kneel before him and cry, the enemy cannot touch me, the lions cannot touch me, for I, my trust and confidence is in you, Lord. Like Pinhas, I will not tolerate sin, Lord. I will not accommodate all that is hurting you will be part of my life, Lord. Create in me the zeal for you, Lord, to a life of holiness, Lord. Cry to him. His healing power is coming upon you. In the name of Jesus, I command every spirit of sickness, every spirit of pain, every spirit of disease, leave these people who are praying along with me. I curse you, O evil spirits, spirit of sickness, spirit of fear, spirit of worries, spirit of discouragement, spirit of peace, all that of not God, to go away from these people of God. May the healing power of the mercy of God come from the divine mercy, and the one hand, the blood comes to cleanse your sin, and the water comes, water of the Spirit of God, the Word of God, to rebuild you. Receive him, receive him, receive him.